There exists today a unique substance taken from mighty trees deep in the centuries-old forest of Portugal. A material that is extremely compressible, yet resilient, possessing extraordinary insulating and fire-retardant properties. A versatile wonder product that is virtually indestructible. Man has attempted to duplicate this exceptional phenomenon, but it is nature that has perfected it. The wonder of cork. Quercus suba is the official Latin name of the cork oak tree. This is a remarkable tree found most abundantly in the occidental Mediterranean basin, with as many as 1,600,000 acres in Portugal alone. There, the trees are nurtured with generous amounts of sunlight and the unusual combination of low rainfall and high humidity. With this large concentration of cork oak trees, it is obvious that Portugal now accounts for approximately 55% of world cork production. The 1995 trade volume broke the 10 billion escudos mark. But what nature has designed, the cork industry now refines in natural composition, granulated or cork rubber combinations, tailor-made in all shapes and sizes. The incredible properties of natural cork are primarily the result of its unique structure. The bark of the cork oak tree is composed of tiny cells, each a 14-sided polyhedron, with the inner cell space entirely filled with air. There are approximately 40 million of these cells in a single cubic centimeter of cork bark. This is the reason that for centuries, cork stoppers have been the primary industry that utilizes cork. These cells give cork an unmatched ability to seal a wine bottle. The cellular membranes are very flexible, making the cork both elastic and compressible. In addition, with a presence of 58% suberin, which makes the cork cells resistant to liquids and gases, cork maintains its great advantage in the bottle stoppers industry. The method of harvesting the cork oak is a laborious effort. It takes 15 to 25 years for the cork oak trunk to reach a perimeter of 25 to 70 centimeters. But a single tree can produce from 160 to 200 years. Its ability to regenerate bark time after time allows for removal of the bark without damage to the tree, which happens in 9-year intervals. The production of usable cork is a multi-step process, beginning with stripping. Summer is the optimum time to extract the cork from the tree, when it is at its vegetative peak. With the help of special axes, the bark is stripped by hand from top to bottom in order not to harm the liber. With the first stripping, an irregular and harder material is obtained called virgin cork. It is not until the third stripping, approximately 27 years later, and those that follow, that cork with excellent properties called reproduction cork is extracted. After stripping, the cork planks are piled up, remaining in this position for 6 months or more. During this time, the cork will experience several chemical transformations brought about by rain, wind, and sun. Following the resting, the cork planks are put into boilers with water heated up by direct steam. The cork remains there for about 90 minutes. The intent of this process is to eliminate insects and flora from the oak forest and to extract contaminants, which eventually makes the cork more flexible. After being boiled, the cork planks are stacked up again, this time for 3 weeks, in order to be smoothed down and to make their cellular structure easier to work with. From the planks, skilled workers have the task of selecting the appropriate quality for the production of cork stoppers. The cork is then cut into strips of a width that slightly exceeds the final length of the cork stopper. The strips are punched into a perpendicular direction to the growth of the cork. By doing so, the lineage cells remain in the transversal position when the cork stopper is inserted into the bottle, reducing the possibility of any leakage caused by the lineage cells. After punching, the material left surrounding the punched cork will be used for champagne cork tops, gaskets, cork flooring, even insulation on NASA's space shuttle. Next, the corks must be washed. The latest systems use rolling cylinders to spin the corks in the liquid. Huge tanks hold carefully monitored chemicals, which are pressure washed into the corks and then rinsed by a similar computer-controlled process. Much of the research concerning washes is done at CTCOR, the cork industry's technical laboratory outside Porto, Portugal. Here they study virtually every factor in cork production and provide research and analysis to the 150 or so international members which sponsor it. Moisture control following washing is a critical element. First, a conveyor belt furnace dries off any surface moisture within minutes of the washing. Then a temperature and humidity controlled room dehydrates them even more. When the stoppers are completely dried, they are branded using ink or fire in appropriate machines. The stoppers are then graded according to a specific number of factors, first by an electronic selection machine, and then for added accuracy by highly trained workers who inspect and quickly judge them for visual quality. Finally, the corks receive a coating of paraffin and silicon that helps them seal the bottle, also allowing them to be removed easily. It's important that the cork stoppers are stored in well-ventilated places free of odors. The temperature must be sustained between 15 and 20 degrees Celsius, with an environmental humidity of 50 to 70%. From tree bark to finished stopper, the process is painstaking, but provides a superior product developed and perfected in Portugal. Now the most important supplier of cork stoppers for wine bottles. The widespread use of this product over the last several centuries has been responsible for the creation of high-quality wine with aging capabilities as we presently know it. While cork stoppers make up the largest part of the cork industry, construction and automotive are equally important. Due to cork's remarkable qualities as an acoustic, thermal, and vibratic insulator, and its natural rustic appearance, building construction is one area where cork has been most successful. Cork has inherent power to regain its original shape after being compressed. This, along with its insulating and fire-retardant qualities, makes composition cork such an ideal source for floor tiles, wall cork, and so on. This form of cork has incredible potential. It is available in a whole range of different grades where the granule size, density, binding agent, and other additives vary. The automotive industry has seen great advantages because of these qualities in the usage of cork rubber, as in seals, gaskets, vibration-absorbing pads, and thermal insulation. The fashion industry is the latest to capture the beauty and versatility of natural cork in a wide array of clothing and apparel currently being designed with this wonder product. What's next? The applications of cork are limited only by the imagination. In this age of synthetics and diminishing natural resources, cork continues its process of naturally replenishing the world's supply.
Portuguese cork will be there for today and tomorrow's high-tech requirements and is recognized the world over as the finest closure for wines, champagnes, and other bottle products.
The global market base is the most striking aspect of the Portuguese cork industry. France alone imported more than 20 billion escudos last year. The USA stands in third place among major buyers. The fact that cork is made from bark harvested from living trees has caused European environmentalists to encourage the use of cork over other less natural alternatives. Cork forests not only reduce the need for other polluting industries, they also help clean the air of the pollutants caused by these industries. In fact, the cork forests are among the most regulated agriculture in the world and are considered national treasures that bear the fruit of the future. The natural wonder of cork.